In this video, we're going to be talking about all the ionic compounds and also the electron dot system, the Lewis electron dot system associated with them. And we are starting right now. Hey, this is Atvait. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to build your memory, build your brain by uncovering fascinating facts and clear academic concepts, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell notification so that you don't miss anything. Our academic teacher is going to be taking over from here. So let's go.
Today we will talk about the electrovalent bond or the ionic bonds, in other words, and Lewis electronic dot representation. But before we go into this, we need to be clear about certain things so that we can understand the ionic bonds thoroughly. So first thing is about valency shell and the valency electrons. So what is a valency shell? It is nothing but the outermost shell of an atom, and valency electrons are the total number of electrons in the outermost shell. For example, if you take sodium represented by Na, the atomic number of it is 11. Okay. This is the nucleus, first shell, second, so 11, right? So it should be 2, 8, 1. This will be the nucleus. So this is the K shell having 2 electrons, and L shell having 8 electrons, K shell, N shell, M shell, and the outermost shell, M shell here, having only 1 electron. Now what is a valency shell here? It is the M shell. And valency electrons, how many electrons are there in the outermost shell? It's just 1. So valency electron for sodium is only 1. So this is about valency shell and valency electrons. The next we should be clear is about the noble gases. Many noble gases we have, such as argon, radon, neon. If you see all these kind of gases, they have 8 in their outermost, 8 valency electrons in their outermost shell, except for helium, which has got only 2. So what is these noble gases otherwise called? They are called as inert gases. Why? Because once they get 8 valency electrons in their outermost shell, they become chemically unreactive. So what does that mean? Which means you cannot add further electrons in the outermost shell, neither you can remove electrons from the outermost shell. In other words, they won't combine or they won't join together in any chemical reaction. So they are chemically unreactive. In other words, these noble gases, they have attained stability. Okay, so this is called as inert gas electronic configuration. So these noble gases, which has got 8 valency electrons, they have attained the stability. Now, each atom, why they combine with each other? To attain this noble gas configuration, so that they become stable. So why does an atom combine or they bond, they form a chemical bonding? To attain stability. So how does this atom does this? Either by losing electrons or gaining electrons or by sharing electrons. In other words, each atom will try to get stability by having 8 electrons in their valency shell or the outermost shell. Now, we talked about all these noble gases except helium. What about helium? Helium has got only 2 valency electrons. So, how does 2 valency electrons give stability? It can happen only if the outermost shell is the K shell. So helium has got only 1 shell, and that is the K shell. If K shell is the outermost shell of an atom, then 2 electrons are enough to give the atom its stability. Okay. Now, if they have 8 atoms in their valency shell, they are known as to have the octet. And helium 2 is enough for it. So that is called as duplet. Okay, so each atom will try to get this octet position to achieve its stability. And this is done by Either they lose electrons or gain electrons or by sharing the electrons. Now we will talk about ions and atoms. So what are ions and what are atoms? Very simple. Atoms are things which are got equal number of protons and electrons. Protons are equal to electrons. In other words, they carry neutral charge. Okay? Because number of protons equal to number of electrons. What are ions? Protons, number of protons is not equal to number of electrons. So, they might be either positively charged or negatively charged. So, positively charged are known as cations. Negatively charged are known as anions. Okay. So, here the both are equal. Protons and electrons are equal in atoms. That is why they have got a neutral charge. Here, they are unequal. That is why the ions may be a positively charged ions or negatively charged ions. How are ions formed basically? So we have already learned that an atom will try to attain the noble gas, inert noble gas configuration. So how does an ion form? You take sodium for example, it has got 2, 8, 1. Atomic number is 11, so number of electrons is 11 and the valency electron is 1. So now metallic elements, which has got 1, 2, 3 valency electrons in their outermost shell. So they will all try to lose electrons. Why? Because it is easier to lose 1 electron, 2 or 3 electrons rather than gaining 7, 6 and 5 electrons. Because gaining so much electrons will have a lot of energy consideration to happen, which is very quite difficult. So it is more easier for the metallic elements which has got 1, 2, 3 valency electrons in their outermost shell to lose them rather than gaining more number of electrons. So how does this happen in the case of a sodium? So now we know this is sodium atom, okay, which has got 2, 8, 1. Now when this becomes an ion, so what happens? Now sodium has got 1 valency electron. This valency electron, that is 1 in the outermost shell M, this it has to lose to attain the octet configuration, which is stability. In order to attain that, it has to lose this. So when it loses, what happens? We'll just draw the shell so you will be. So this nucleus, this 2 electrons will be there. And here in the L shell, we will have 8 electrons. Now the outermost shell of 1 electron, it will try to lose. So in that case, what happens? The M shell totally vanishes. Okay. So when a sodium atom becomes an ion, the outermost shell having 1 valency electron gets totally removed. Thereby, instead of KLM, it will have a sodium ion will have only KL, thereby 2N8. And see how many electrons are there in the last shell now? 8. So a sodium ion has attained the octet position by losing 1 valency electron. So sodium atom is represented by Na. Now how many number of protons and electrons for it? 11 protons. Electrons is also 11. But if you see here, sodium ion, now how much is there? Protons is still the same, 11. What about electrons? 8 plus 2, 10. So one extra positive charge is there, which is denoted by Na 1 plus. Generally, if it is one number, it is not mentioned. It is just mentioned as plus. So sodium ion will have a plus charge, positive charge of 1. Okay. An atom gets converted to an ion. Why? To attain stability. So here you should be very clear that If you take sodium ion now, a sodium ion is more stable than a sodium atom because it has reached the octet position. Okay, so sodium ion is more stable than a sodium atom because now if you see its valency shell, there are 8 valency electrons. So this has attained more stability than a sodium atom. Okay, now same way we can check, do for other elements also. So now let's take potassium, which is represented by K, whose atomic number is 19. So K, L, M, N, B, 2, 8, 10, 18, 19. Now, it has got one valency electron in its outermost shell. So for the potassium atom to gain stability, it has to lose or minus one electron. So when one electron is gone, so this is vanished. Now if you see outermost shell 8 is there, the whole shell goes, the end shell totally vanishes. M will become the outermost shell where 8 is achieved. But what happens? Atom has got 19 protons and 19 electrons. Now once one electron is removed from the atom, then what happens? Proton will be 19, electron will be minus 1, so that is 18. So potassium ion will have a positive charge of 1. And potassium ion is more stable than a potassium atom because it has attained octet position. Okay, because now the outer shell will be M for a potassium ion. And M has got 8 valency electrons, thereby it has attained stability. Now we will take magnesium atom. So magnesium atom, I am not writing KLMN, which you already know, has got an atomic number of 12. So that should be 282. So for the magnesium atom to attain stability, it has to lose these two electrons, right? So once it loses, what happens? Now K, L will become the outermost shell, it loses 2. So magnesium atom will become a magnesium ion with 2 electrons are lost with 2 positive charge. So this is how a magnesium ion is formed. The same way you can try for calcium, which is again a plus 2 charge. Now we will check out with how an aluminium ion is formed, which is represented by Al, whose atomic number is 13. So 13 will be 2, 8, 3 valency electrons aluminium atom has got in its valency shell. So aluminium atom has to lose these 3 electrons to attain stability and to become an ion. So when 3 electrons are lost, aluminium atom will become an aluminium ion with plus 3 positive charge. Now we will see Lewis dot representation. So what does this dot represents? The dot represents the valency electrons, each dot representing one valency electron. For example, sodium has got one valency electron. So just write the name of the element and put a dot 1. One dot represents one valency electron. Sodium has got one valency electron. So we are just going to put 1 dot. So takes, for example, magnesium has got 2 valency electrons. So 1, 2. Aluminium has got 3 valency electrons. 1, 2, 3. See, basically you can put this in any arrangement. But if there is only one valency electron, I would prefer you to put on the side, either this side or this side. So that when it combines with other elements, it will be easier to put the schematic diagram, which we'll be dealing later in the later sessions. Okay, so aluminium is 3 valency electrons, so 1, 2, 3 dots. Then we have calcium, 2 valency electrons, so same way, calcium 2 valency electrons represent. And one more, we can take potassium, 1 valency. So this is the electronic dot representation, like each dot representing each valency electrons. Now we have dealt with cations, how cations are formed from metallic atoms. Now we will go to anions. Now let's take for example chlorine. Chlorine atom has got an atomic number, chlorine represented by Cl. Its number is 17. Okay. That will be 2, 8, 7 in its outermost shell, that is a valency shell. So chlorine atom will require, see, it's not possible for the chlorine atom to remove 7 electrons because you require a lot of energy to remove electrons. Okay, and removing 7 is not a joke. So since a lot of energy is required in removing, it is easier for the non-metallic atoms to gain electrons rather than losing electrons to attain the octet position. So now it has got 7 valency electrons. So it just requires one more electron to have number 8. So plus 1 electron will be easier for it. So when it receives plus, so here you see proton 17, electron 17. So charge is neutral in a chlorine atom. Now here it receiving one more. So chlorine ion, chlorine when it becomes an ion, it is named as chloride, right? Chlorine becomes chloride ion with one electron added. Electrons are negatively charged, so it will be minus one this side. Anyway, one is not represented, so it will be chlorine. Okay, so from a chlorine atom, chloride ion is formed. And chloride ion has a negative charge of 1, which is nothing but a anion. Okay. Same way, if we take, now let's do the electronic dot representation for this side by side. So what happens, a chlorine atom has got 7 valency electrons, right? So let's put dot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now it requires one more. So if it requires one more, it becomes 8. Now, see, the chloride ion has 8 electrons, valency electrons. So it has attained stability. But from an atom, it has turned to chloride ion. So minus. So this will be net effect. Now next, the fluorine will turn to fluoride. Okay, same way. For fluorine atom, it is 9. So, 2, 7. So, it requires one more. So, when one more electron is added, fluorine atom becomes a fluoride ion with a negative charge of 1. Now, we'll take the oxide ion, which is formed from oxygen atom. Change to oxide ion. How it is done? Now oxygen has got atomic number of 8, and so that will be 2 and a 6. So this requires 2 more electrons to achieve the octet position. Okay. So now when 2 more electrons are added, so let's draw it. Now O, how will we represent? It has got 6 valency electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this oxygen atom, once it receives 2 more electrons, okay, here it received 2 more electrons. So now it has got 8 electrons in its valency shell. So it has attained stability, but 2 electrons are added, so 2 negative charges, so it will be 2 minus. So in other words, oxide ion will have a negative charge of 2. So remember, an oxide ion is more stable than an oxygen atom because it has got 8 valency electrons and it has attained the inert gas configuration. Whereas an oxygen atom has got only 6 valency electrons. Okay, now we will see the nitride ion, which is formed from a nitrogen atom. Nitrogen atomic number is 7. So that will be 2 and 5. So this requires 3 more electrons to get the octet position. So when it gets 3 more electrons, so before that we'll just draw. So it has got 5 valency electrons, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it requires 3 more. This is a nitrogen atom. When it acquires 3 more electrons, so now there are 8 electrons in its valency shell. Nitrogen atom will change to nitride ion. And how many electrons are added? 3 electrons, 3 negative charge. So nitride ion will be N3-. Now, what is an ionic bond? It is a bond which is created by the transfer of electrons between the atoms. So what do you mean by transfer? Transfer itself means something has to give, okay? Something has to give and something has to take. So which gives electrons? All the metals. Which takes electrons? Generally the non-metals. Remember, there are two non-metals which are positive ions. Those are hydrogen and ammonium. So except for those two, all other non-metals will try to take electrons to achieve the inert gas configuration. And all metal elements will try to give electrons to attain the stability. So then what happens? So here, the metallic ions, that is positively charged ions, mixed with or get bonded with negatively charged ions. First of all, they are opposite charges. So the attraction will be so strong electrostatic attraction is formed between them. And this is called as the ionic bond. And what is an ionic compound? Ionic compound is a compound formed basically with these ionic bonds. So when you immediately see a metal and a non-metal combining and forming a bond, you should immediately say it is an ionic bond. Okay? And all ionic compounds are made of ionic bonds. Now let's see how an ionic compound is formed. So let's take sodium chloride, NaCl. Okay. The sodium has one valency electron. Okay, put a dot. So it's going to mix with chlorine atom, which has got 7 valency electrons. So how do you represent? So now sodium atom has to lose one electron to gain octet, and chlorine has to gain one electron. So this electron goes here. So what happened? Now immediately sodium atom will become an ion with positive one, because only one electron has gone, and chlorine would have received one electron. So chlorine atom would have become an ion with a minus one charge. Generally, the ion's charges are not written in the chemical formula. So this will be nothing but NaCl. Okay. So this is one of the ionic compound. Let's take another one, potassium chloride. QCl. So how is this formed? Now potassium is again has got one valency electron. Because potassium atomic number is 19, so that will be 2881, so one valence electron. And of course chlorine requires one, we saw that. So this electron will move here, potassium atom will become an ion with positive charge, combining with chlorine atom after receiving one electron becomes chloride ion with a minus charge. So that will be potassium chloride. Now let's see magnesium chloride. This is represented by MgCl2. Let's see how this is formed. So magnesium atom has got two valency electrons, combined with fluorine atom, it's got 7. Now look here, chlorine requires only one, but magnesium has got two electrons to dispose of. So what to do with another one electron? No problem. So that will be taken by another fluorine atom. So what happens? One electron moves to this chlorine atom, another one moves to this chlorine atom. Now magnesium will become an ion with positive charge of 2. And now we have two chlorine atoms. So this chlorine atom will become an ion with minus 1. This will become an ion with minus 1. Minus 1 plus minus 1, minus 2. So the charges becomes equal. Then there are two chlorine ions. So write 2 chloride becomes 2 chloride. So 2Cl. So this with a minus 1. There are two chloride ions. Chloride ions having a minus 1 charge. This can be written as MgCl2. So this 2 will come over to the bottom. And charges, of course, we don't write the ionic charges. So this becomes MgCl2. So one more we will see. Magnesium oxide, which is MgO. Magnesium 2 plus an oxygen atom, which has got 6. Now magnesium has to lose 2. Oxygen requires 2 electrons. So both will go to this oxygen. Magnesium will become an ion with positive charge of 2, combining with oxide ion with a negative charge of 2, becomes MgO, magnesium oxide compound. Next one, we have the sodium oxide. Sodium oxide represented by Na2O. So let's see how this is formed. Sodium valency electron 1, combining with oxygen valency electron of 6. Now see here, oxygen requires 2, but sodium has got only 1. Again, no issues. Another sodium will contribute. So another sodium atom has got 1 valency electron. So this 1 valency electron will come from this sodium. Another one will come from this sodium. Thereby oxygen will gain 2 electrons. Now we have here, sodium atom will become an ion with a positive charge of 1. There are 2 sodium atoms. So Na plus, Na plus combines with oxygen ion of 2 minus. So this can be written as 2Na plus O 2 minus. This can be written as Na2O. So that is the chemical formula for sodium oxide. Very important thing you should remember is, if there is a metal and a non-metal combining with each other, it forms an ionic compound, and this ionic compound consists of ionic bonds.
Now if you want to build your memory, build your brain, or clear academic concepts, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so that you don't miss anything, and watch the most relevant video you find linked on the screen right now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.